What's up, Army? Episode 3. I want to talk to you guys today about learning to turn down work, learning to say no to customers because of the risk or anything like that. I'm going to give you a prime example. A 2014 Kit Cobra Factory 5 was painted by a shop near here, by a reputable shop, might I say. And they did a really bad job finishing it, so the customer brought it to me to sand it and finish it out. It had a bunch of dry spray, cloudiness, and like clumps of clear coat dry spray in random areas. So it needed a pretty good sanding. It wasn't going to be with 25. It was only with 3000 grit. I did a test spot and it was taking everything out quite well. It was using Norton Ice fabric pads with water, distilled water. And I did a test spot, compounded it, came out beautiful. Then I got to the hood and I sanded half the hood, and then I noticed that part of the passenger fender was fine, didn't have any dry spray on it, so I decided to compound from the bottom up and work my way forward. And I got up to the top corner once I finished the hood and noticed that I had burnt through a little spot. And this is with a Rupes with Zephyr polish on a Eurofiber pad on speed 4. And it's been 12 years since I've burnt paint with anything, and I didn't even burn it with a rotary. I burnt it with a fucking sander on a fresh Dodge paint that just came out of the booth 2 hours ago, you know. So it was one of those things where I didn't know what I was doing. I was also a young kid. I was 17 years old, and it happened, right? That was the last time I burnt anything with any machine ever. My speculation is that there wasn't a lot of clear coat on this car, so I called the customer. I let him know. He said, all right, is it really bad? And I said, no, you can hardly notice it, but I'm going to pay for it to get it fixed, because I thought at the time this is the only spot that's going to be troublesome. So then he was okay with it. He was like, yeah, whatever, as long as it gets fixed right. Anyway, so then I got to the hood. I started correcting the sanding marks out of the hood. Everything was going well. And then all of a sudden I wiped and noticed that there was another light spot forming on the hood in the same fashion. And I said, Jesus Christ, what is going on? So I called them again and I said, I'm not comfortable working on this car. The hood's doing the same thing. I don't think there's a lot of clear coat in this car. Judging by the quality of this paint job, I don't think there's enough clear coat on the car for me to even polish it. So I'm not going to do anything until I get the paint measured, and I can go do that at the body shop down the street. Mind you, it's a glass body, and detectors that can split layers and measure glass are fucking expensive, so I don't have one. So I decided that I was going to take it to a body shop or this custom shop or hot rod shop down the road here, and it didn't even get to that point. The owner and I had several phone calls. He came down and looked at it, and he said, oh, Jesus, you made me think you burnt through all the way to the fiberglass. I was like, no, I don't use anything that aggressive. It's just a tiny little light spot in the clear coat. And he's like, all right, that's not a big deal. So he's like, let me know what you think. Let me know what happens. So he left. Then he called me again at the end of the day, and he goes, you know what, forget it. I called the body shop that did it. They're going to repaint the whole car. They're going to fix it, do whatever they need to do to fix it. We're talking about a brand new shell here. You don't see Corvettes looking like that. You don't see McLarens or any carbon fiber or fiberglass-based body and chassis ever look like that. And that's because they're doing it right. This shop cut corners, and they didn't do it right. My guess is they dry sprayed half the car. Somebody was learning how to paint, didn't do it right. They held the gun too far away, or they didn't do enough wet coats, or they were using too much air and it was drying the clear coat prematurely, or they didn't mix the clear coat right. There's so many factors that can cause dry spray, and he could have fulfilled one of them or all of them. And I think what they did was they tried to wet sand all of it out and make it look as good as possible, and they sent it. And that's why there was no clear coat left on the car. They're not going to reveal to me what they did, because they don't want to take the blame for something, even though he already did. So this was a really big pain in my ass, because I'm thinking, great, my insurance company's going to fucking hate me, because now I got to pay for this $10,000 paint job to be done on this car. And, you know, I could have avoided it by saying no to the customer. If you're wet sanding, you need to find out who painted it and what they painted it with and how long ago they painted it. So these kind of situations can be really harrowing. Make sure you have insurance. Make sure you know what's going on. Make sure you know how to talk to the customer, cater to the customer. Make sure you know whether or not it was negligence on your part or somebody else's part. Either way, it happened in your possession and you're partly responsible for it to get fixed. Luckily, it turns out that the shop took responsibility and they're going to fix everything on the car. It's not going to be an issue. Thankfully, thank God that this guy is a great customer and a good client, and he's going to get it taken care of with the guy who did it, which should have been my first answer. But, you know, I try to provide a good service for people, and when I know that I can do something, I say, yeah, sure, I can do that for you. It's not like a yes-to-death situation. I do put some thought into it, and like I said, my check boxes were checked. It was painted by a good shop. I got all the information on the paint, and I knew that it could handle being wet sanded because it was fresh, new paint, and it looked like it had a lot of clear coat on it, but it really didn't. Sadly, these situations do happen to less fortunate people who are just starting out in business with no insurance. So my advice to you guys is make sure that you have insurance. It's cheap. I pay $43 a month for insurance. There's no reason why you guys can't pay for garage keepers and liability insurance. I have $2 million liability, $10,000 tool, and $500,000 garage keepers insurance. My liability insurance would have covered that no problem. I have a $250 deductible. Boom, get it fixed. It would have been done. That's that. So I hope you guys learned something. Any questions or concerns, if you've run into the situation and you need my advice or help, please feel free to let me know. Message me on Facebook. Join Detail Army on Facebook. It's got the picture of the McLaren P1. That's how you know it's a group, because there's two. One's a group and one's a page. Mine's the group. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and have a good day.